My name is Rick Reinhardt, and I'm here at the ECW Arena with Nikita Koloff. Nikita, how are you today?
Jatoita. I'm doing great, comrade. Legendary, right? The legendary ECW Arena. Sir. I've never been here before, so it's great to see where all the action took place.
Yeah. I was here at a lot of those shows back in the day, and it's so cool to see how people from different territories are now coming through Philly the way they are. Any comments on the old territories?
I'm excited about what's happening right now in the world of wrestling with Billy Corgan and the NWA, the old studio wrestling back in Atlanta. I think it brought back memories when I watched the show. So I'm excited about what he and Dave Lagana and the guys are doing with Nick Aldis with NWA. Obviously being a loyal NWA guy that I was over the years. And Cody Rhodes, you know, obviously, you know, son of the superpowers.
Yeah.
AEW and just a Ring of Honor, just everything. WWE, all of the wrestling that's going on the indie circuit. I'm just excited about it for the fans.
Yes.
For the fans.
Yes. You know, I've been to the spirituality stuff, and you know, you can feel Dusty almost booking these matches, you know, from the clouds or something. It's real crazy. is there anything you want to talk about, like with any of the spiritual stuff with pro wrestling?
Well, I would say, I don't know about combining the two. That's an interesting combination there. But what I will say is, obviously, Cody is Pat. So some of that brain power and the creative ideas that Dusty had is certainly passed down to Cody Rhodes.
I think that's what I'm picking up on.
I think that's evident. You know, just kind of a generational thing going on there he got a lot of the creativity. And I'm sure growing up around it and hearing conversations with his dad, you know, with others, certainly probably helped him out as well.
Yeah. Definitely,
you
know, got to absorb it from one of the best, you know.
Yeah.
So, any good, any stuff you want to talk about with any feuds you were in with Dusty or like with Magnum TA or any of these guys, man?
Well, if I glance over to my right now, I see the nemesis of my early days, Mega TA. Yeah, certainly the number one thing most talked about by wrestling fans by far is the best of seven with Magnum TA. And we've done a lot of dual co-ops today, photo ops, I should say, today. People are like, oh, I want a picture with both you guys. And so, you know, we're doing that. So, you know, the best of seven, again, another creation of Dusty, the best of seven. And so that was the number one thing I get that's talked about. Maybe behind that, maybe the original War Games, certainly another one. And then I would be remiss not to say the coalition of the superpowers. Death the Roll, the American Dream, the Tower of Power, too sweet to be power, if you will.
Yeah.
And so just the coalition, the formation of the superpowers with Dusty and I, and the great run that we had together as the superpowers, sometimes teaming up with the Road Warriors against the Four Horsemen, which certainly brings back great memories as well.
So I want to say two questions just because I don't want to forget either of them. I think both are very important. So you're from the great wrestling state of Minnesota, right?
Yeah, via Moscow.
Yeah. The Moscow side of Minnesota.
The Moscow connection. Yeah, the Moscow side of Minnesota. Yes, I am from the great state of Minnesota.
A lot of guys from there, man.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. One day they'll do a documentary on Robbinsdale High School. Myself, Rick Rude, the Ravishing One, Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig, Tom Zink,
some of the best.
John Nord, Brady Boone.
John Nord, the Berserker?
The Berserker,
okay.
Barry Darso. All of us came out of the same high school. Five of us played on the same high school football team one time. And then two other notables out of Robbinsdale High School was a guy named Mean Gene Okerlund. And Vern Gagne.
Wow.
How about that?
Wow.
A lot of history just in that one school.
Bischoff from there?
No.
Okay.
Not from my high school anyway.
Okay, all right.
But and then outside of that, I mean, there's so many other guys. Scott Norton and obviously Jesse Ventura and Wayne Bloom and Mike Enos. The list goes on and on and on from all the guys. Right? The Road Warriors. Hawk and Animal, right?
Wow.
Minneapolis and New Brighton, Minnesota. So a mecca of professional wrestling, right?
Yeah.
Well, anyway.
In the same era, too. Like, that's crazy.
Yeah, quite a bit. I mean, quite a bit of the same era. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I hope I didn't forget that other question that I was going to ask, but I might have. You know,
you're drawing a blank.
I'm drawing blank, and it was a good one, too, and I just can't remember it. So.
Well, it's all good. Hey, I appreciate all the fans, always. So all you out there, whoever view and watch this video, just appreciate all of you. Hey, you can follow me on Instagram, right? Nikita Koloff with a number one behind it. Don't get the imposters. Get the real one. You can follow me on Twitter. I do have a Facebook page. I'll mention this, too. There's a guy by the name of The Total Package.
Yes.
Lex Luger, and some fans are aware of, some are not, but he and I have tag-teamed now over the last several years, and we do a lot of ministry together.
Oh, cool.
In fact, we do a camp for men. We do a camp for men and just pour into them everything we've learned. You mentioned spirituality,
yeah.
But physical, you know, Lex was a physical specimen in his day, right?
Yeah.
Physical, having the right mental attitude, the right mindset, you know, and so we just take men for a handful of days. They can check that out on mancamp.info.
Okay.
They can find information on that as well.
Okay.
Come spend a few days with The Total Package, Lex Luger, and the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. Chateau Etat.
Ah. I think I just remembered that question, actually.
Go ahead. We're about out of time. I'm looking at your camera guy here.
Yeah. He's squirming over there. So I remember the old publications of the Pro Wrestling Illustrated,
okay,
which is where we actually got our name from, the Pro Wrestling Archives.
Okay.
I remember you were toe-to-toe with Hogan in a lot of those rankings.
Yep, they tried to. And Bill Apter, who was one of the main catalysts of Pro Wrestling Illustrated, who's wandering around the arena here, who dear friend of mine now for many years, through the business, we became just really great friends. He was a catalyst in that, and kind of promoting what if Nikita Koloff wrestled Hulk Hogan.
I remember that.
Yeah, he was. Bill Apter was a real catalyst in all of that. So
that's so cool.
Yeah, it never happened, but it leaves for the video games, right? You can you can make create it on the video game and have fun, right?
Yeah,
there you go.
No, it was cool because I remember, you know, as a kid, I'd go to the Wawa and pro wrestling magazines would be everywhere, and it's like, man, you know, instead of getting the porno mags, you get the pro wrestling mags, man. And you know what I mean? Like,
probably a better choice. Yeah, probably a better choice. And
some knowledge, you know.
But if, hey, I'll say this. If you do create us on the video game, you just make sure I come out on top, okay? One, two, three.
This is beautiful.
Rick Reinhardt here at the Pro Wrestling Archives with Nikita Koloff at the ECW Arena saying thank you.
Ah.